गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस आर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज सेंटेंस एनालिसिस। सो वी नो दैट सेंटेंस इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स विच मेक्स द कंप्लीट सेंस। प्रीति सिंग्स, मीरा टीचिज डांस, द चिल्ड्रन वॉक्ड होम, द प्राइस ऑफ दिस शर्ट इज 500 rupees। सो ऑल ऑफ द अबव सेंटेंसेज आर सिंपल सेंटेंसेज। वेन वी एनालाइज सिंपल सेंटेंस वी मस्ट फर्स्ट आइडेंटिफाई द टू मेन वर्ब्स, सब्जेक्ट एंड द प्रेडिकेट। सी द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ सेंटेंस मे बी a word or a phrase which tells us who, what is being talked about, or what, who does an action. So example, children play. So children is subject here because children are doing an action. Next is all the members attended the meeting. So all the members, here is an example of subject. The predicate is part of sentence that tells us something about the subject. So all the members, as we know, all the members is subject, and attended the meeting is an example of predicate because rest of the sentence is considered as predicate. The predicate may be a single finite verb or may be a verb with an object or some more words that are needed to complete the meaning of sentence. See example, I sing, my friends gave me a bouquet of flowers. Subject predicate, Preeti sings, Meera teaches dance, the children walked home, the price of shirt is 500 rupees. See example, the subject may consist of one word or many words. In first sentence, the subject has one word, Preeti. In sentence 4, however, the subject has 5 words. In predicate 2, may consist of one word or group of words. In sentence 1, and the predicate has one word, sings. And in sentence 4, however, there are 4 words in the predicate. See example. Next is subject word and its attributes. When the subject of the sentence has more than one word, all these words together make the complete sense. In this set of words, the more important word is called subject word or simple subject. See example, the 5 brothers lived together in the jungle. In the first sentence, subject word is the noun brothers because this is more important word in the sentence. In the second sentence, the word walking is subject word. In the third sentence, the infinitive to love does the work of a noun and is the subject word. Subject word attribute. Next is, we are talking about subject word attribute. In a sentence, the subject word is often qualified by an adjective or the words that do the work of an adjective. So this is called attribute. The attribute may be an adjective, participle or participial. Adjective, an infinitive, a pronoun, an article or a phrase. See example, the man stood at the door. The man stood at the door. Let's analyze the subject in this sentence. See example, the man. Subject is the man. And subject word is man because man is noun and is more important word in the sentence. See the attribute. Attribute is the, definite article the. Next is, Mahatma Gandhi, the father of nation, was assassinated. Mahatma Gandhi, the father of nation, subject here. And more important word, which is called subject word, is Mahatma Gandhi. And its attribute is the father of nation, that is noun phrase. So this is an example of subject word attribute. Next is the predicate. The predicate may consist of just one word or the group of words. When the predicate has only one word, it will be called, it will always be a verb. We know that every predicate must have a finite verb. See example, the class starts at 9, 3 words in the predicate. In the predicate, the verb may be qualified by an adverb or a group of verbs that do the work of an adverb. This is called adverbial qualification. So predicate must consist of group of words or maybe just one word. When the predicate has one word, it will always be verb. So In the predicate, the verb may be qualified by an adverb or a group of words that do the work of an adverb. See example, the children waited downstairs. The adverbial qualification is an adverb. Waited is a verb and downstairs is an example of adverbs. The children came home, a noun that behaves like an adverb of place. So, these are adverbial qualification in which the verb may be qualified by an adverb. Next is the object of a verb. The object of a verb, when we use a verb transitively, we need an object to make the meaning of sentence complete. Means transitive verbs need an object to complete their meaning. See example, I threw the ball. The words I threw do not make complete sense by themselves because the verb threw is transitive. It needs the object ball for the sentence to be completed. Next is the object of transitive verb may be the following. A noun, we flew kites. Example of pronoun, a thief stole it. An adjective that does the work of a noun, ordinary people envy the rich. A participle that act as a noun, everybody enjoys singing. An infinite that does the work of a noun, the concerned tiger tried to attack. A group of words doing the work of a noun, Hina loves to bake chocolate cakes. Example of a noun clause, do you remember what Ansari told us about this building? When an object consists of more than one word, we have the object word and its attribute, just like we have attributes for subject word. The mother scolded the naughty child. Here child is object word and the naughty are its attributes. Same with subject word. Direct and indirect objects. Very often we require two objects with transitive verb. Look at this sentence. This sentence, Payal gave Rupa a book. Here we have two objects of verb, give. When we ask the question, Payal gave what? We get the answer, a book, which is called the direct object of the verb. If we ask whom the book was given to, we get the answer, Rupa. So, the word Rupa is then the indirect object of verb, gave. So, now we have read the difference between direct and indirect objects. Next is complement. The complement. Look at these sentences. Geeta walks. Kartika appears unhappy. The predicate in the first sentence consists of a single verb, walk, which is an intransitive verb. The sentence is complete in itself. In the second sentence, we just say Kartika appears. If we just say Kartika appears, it will not be correct. The intransitive verb appears require a word or group of words to complete its meaning. The verb appears is an intransitive verb of incomplete predication. Sometimes the verb in the predicate is an intransitive verb, but it is incomplete by itself. It requires a noun, a pronoun, or an adjective to complete the predicate. The word or group of words required to complete the predicate is called complement. The complement of an intransitive verb describes the subject. It is therefore called subject complement. So, the subject complement may be the following. See an example of a noun. Mercury is a planet. So, an adjective, the children were hungry. Hungry is an adjective here, which is an example of subject complement. A pronoun, this is him. Him is an example of pronoun. A participle, mother seemed agitated. An infinitive, the child appeared to shudder. To shudder is an infinitive. An adverb, the smoke is everywhere. A group of words doing the work of an adjective. The second-hand car was in an excellent condition. A clause, home is where the hurt is. So these are examples of subject complement. So this is all about sentence analysis. I hope you understand this chapter well.